Okay, so this is gonna be my review of Tatsunoko VS Capcom Ultimate All Stars. I've actually had this game only for a week, but so far I'm pretty good with almost all the Capcom characters. I don't play as Tatsunoko very often, and if I do, it's usually the big gold guy. First thing I think you noticed was the character roster. It's fairly decent. I think it's a little smaller than Marvel VS Capcom, but and that's just me. The character special attacks and everything, they're pretty useful when you're just using the Wiimote and a nunchuck, because you could put it into a simplified mode and you're able to pull off all your special moves a lot faster and a whole lot easier. Like, you use a Duken is 100% easier, and I don't know how easy you could get from quarter circle forward, but they did it. I'm playing as mostly Frank and Zero because I've played a lot as Frank, and Zero's pretty easy to learn. You just have to press these buttons in the order, which is light hit, medium hit, and heavy hit, and you basically got a really good combo going on. Frank is a lot harder because he doesn't have any charge moves, but it's more like the Z moves for like the Hadouken. But since you have to pull these off so often to get anything working, it gets annoying. Other characters, such as Roll, gives you a height advantage because of her size. A couple of high character hits won't hit her. Ryu and everyone else is basically the same. So if you've played as anyone else in the Capcom series, they pretty much give it away right then and there. Other characters such as Yadaman, number one, the thing from Lost Planet, they pretty much give you a good variety of moves, but again, they're more or less difficult to pull off if you're not using a simplified control. Another thing about this game is it has a lot of nostalgic to it, such as Mega Man Volnut, because I haven't seen Mega Man Volnut in a long time. I'm really glad to see him back in action, though his move list could be a little more productive. I mean, his Buster Cannon, not really much more than a little pea shooter that takes too long to fire. And he does have a really good set list, but only for those who can understand how to use them. Some of his moves are a lot more difficult to pull off, depending on his whatever weapons on his arm. If there is no weapon on his arm, he's just using the basic kick attack, which even in the game, which in the original game didn't do much more than just kick someone back, but in this one, at least it does major or minor damage, depending on how far away your opponent is. Other characters, such as June the Swan, comes equipped with a couple of, I guess you'd call it cheat moves, such as this one where she basically hits you with about 5 or 10, depending on depending on range, attacks that could really do damage. Such characters such as Frank, as you just saw, couldn't use special attacks against extremely large opponents. G Lightning was the fact of life there. And of course, with Frank, you get a little bit of a Dead Rising feel to it. It's kind of sad, though, that the Wii was able to produce that many zombies in this game, but in Frank's game on the Wii, I'm sorry, I didn't even play it, and it just sucked. And so, well, I guess I should stop talking. I'll let you listen in on more of the Tatsunoko VS Capcom soundtrack, and hey, watch the rest of these guys get their asses handed to them.
What was it? get you worked up.
What the hell?